وبركاته. In our lab today, we will discuss two important sexually transmitted diseases. First, Neisseria gonorrhea or gonococci, which cause gonorrhea. Then, spirochetes, mainly Treponema pallidum, which cause syphilis. What are our objectives? To remember family Neisseria, to identify morphology, cultural characters, biochemical reactions of gonococci, and to identify also what are the methods of diagnosis of gonorrhea. Then to identify classification of spirochetes. Finally, to explain methods of diagnosis of syphilis. We will start with Neisseria gonorrhea or gonococci. Previously, we mentioned family Neisseria in neuro module. We mentioned Neisseria meningitidis, which is a cause of meningitis. What are family Neisseria? They are gram negative cocci. This family is classified into two primary human pathogens: Neisseria meningitidis, meningococci, which cause meningitis; Neisseria gonorrhea, gonococci, which cause gonorrhea. Other Neisseria, as Neisseria flavescens and Neisseria sicca, are commensals. Here in reproduction module, the most important for us is Neisseria gonorrhea or gonococci. As we mentioned, it causes sexual transmitted disease called gonorrhea. What is gonorrhea? Gonorrhea is a disease transmitted sexually, affect both male and female. Male gonorrhea present with acute anterior urethritis with purulent urethral discharge and dysuria in acute stage. Then in a chronic stage, it presents with scanty discharge called the morning drop and may be complicated by urethral stricture, prostatitis, and epididymitis. Female gonorrhea present with cervicitis and urethritis with mucopurulent discharge, may progress to salpingitis, pelvic inflammatory disease. Gonorrhea not affect the vagina due to its acidity and the presence of normal human microbiota prevent colonization with pathogenic organisms. Other forms of gonorrhea may occur as anorectal or throat infection, occur mainly in heterosexual women or homosexual men. Gonorrhea may be complicated by a condition called disseminated gonococcal infection, where blood invasion occurs and present with septic arthritis, tenosynovitis, skin pustules, and rarely may progress to endocarditis. This is gonorrhea. What are other diseases caused by gonococci? May cause ophthalmia neonatorum, infection of the newborn acquired from the birth canal of gonococcal mother, and may lead to corneal affection and blindness. Also, Neisseria gonorrhea may cause vulvovaginitis in young girls due to sexual abuse. This is a hint about the diseases and clinical picture caused by gonococci. In our practical lab, we focus on the methods of bacteriological diagnosis of gonococcal infection. How to diagnose these diseases or how to diagnose gonococcal infection. First of all, specimen collection, then smear preparation, then cultivation. And the culture is identified by colony morphology, film preparation, and biochemical reactions. Laboratory diagnosis of gonorrhea. As we mentioned, the first step is to collect our specimen. Our specimen, in case of acute male urethritis, is urethral discharge. In chronic male infections, acute or chronic female infections, we collect our specimen as discharge from the urethra, cervix, rectum, conjunctiva, throat, or synovial fluid according to the clinical presentation. If there is urethritis, take urethral discharge. Rectal infection, specimen from the rectum. Conjunctival infection, specimen from the conjunctiva, and so on. After specimen collection, the first step to do direct microscopic examination. Direct Gram stained smear of urethral discharge. This step is diagnostic in case of acute male gonorrhea only. In case of acute male gonorrhea, detection of gonococci in urethral specimen is diagnostic. What will be seen in Gram stained smear? We comment on our items, stain, shape, arrangement, motility, capsule, and spores. To describe this organism, we should comment on these items. We will see indirect smear, gram negative cocci, arranged in pairs, so-called diplococci, with adjacent sides flattened, giving kidney-shaped appearance. These organisms present intracellularly, in pus cells, and extracellularly. They are non-motile, non-capsulated, and non-spore-forming. As we see, these are polymorph nuclear leukocytes, pus cells, and the organism is present both intracellularly and extracellularly. Also, the same description. After direct microscopic examination, the second step is culture. What are the cultural characters of Neisseria gonorrhea? First, oxygen requirement. They are aerobes, require moist atmosphere and 5 to 10% CO2 to enhance growth. Type of media. They grow on chocolate agar, which is enriched media, and on modified Sayer Martin, which is selective media. Temperature requirement 35 to 37 degrees. Time for growth 24 to 48 hours. Let's remember chocolate agar. Chocolate agar is enriched medium. Its composition is heated blood agar. Its color is opaque brown. And it is used for growing fastidious bacteria as Neisseria and Haemophilus. What is the colony morphology of Neisseria gonorrhea on chocolate agar? The colonies are small, non-pigmented or translucent, raised or convex, and smooth colonies. Small, smooth, translucent, convex colonies. The second medium, which is a selective medium for Neisseria gonorrhea, is modified Sayer-Martin medium. Modified Sayer-Martin is selective medium for Neisseria, composed of chocolate agar and three antibiotics, which are nystatin, colistin, and vancomycin. They are the selective substances which prevent the growth of other organisms. On modified Sayer-Martin agar colony morphology, the colonies are small, grayish white to translucent, convex, smooth or mucoid colonies. As we mentioned, the culture is identified by colony morphology, the film preparation, and biochemical reaction. The film, the organism, appear as in smear but without pus cells. The organism appear as gram-negative diplococci with adjacent sides flattened, giving kidney-shaped appearance. Non-motile, non-capsulated, and non-spore forming. Then, biochemical reactions. Family Neisseria are oxidase positive. This is the first important biochemical reaction. They are oxidase positive. Then, sugar fermentation. Neisseria gonorrhea ferment glucose only. What is an oxidase test? It is a test, a type of biochemical reaction, enzyme production test, done to detect if the organism produces oxidase enzyme. How to make oxidase test? Strip of filter paper, impregnated with oxidase reagent, smeared with a colony of the organism. If dark blue or deep purple color appears, this indicates a positive test. This oxidase strip colony on the loop on the oxidase strip ونشوف الكالر بتاعنا. Second important biochemical reaction is sugar fermentation test. Sugar fermentation test البرنسبل بتاعه زي ما قلنا ان احنا بنجيب تيست تيوبس بنحط فيها الشجر وبنحط التيوب المقلوبة دي اللي هي الدرهامز تيوب وبنحط ال pH indicator او الكالر indicator. لو استعملنا الفينول ريد از indicator الكنترول بتاعي بيبقى لونه لون الفينول ريد اللي هو الاحمر ولو حصل برودكشن لاسيد بيتحول للون اليلو اللي هو اللون الاصفر. لو حصل برودكشن اوف جاز بيظهر لي الجاز بابل في الايبكس بتاعه الدرهامز تيوب. لو استعملنا الاندرويدز انديكيتور ده عكس الفينول ريد بيبقى الكنترول بتاعي لونه يلو او لونه اصفر، ولو حصل فيرمنتيشن بيتحول للون البينك، ولو طلع جاز او حصل برودكشن اوف جاز بشوف برضو الجاز بابل في الايبكس بتاعت الديرهامز تيوب. ده البرنسيبل بتاع الشوجر فيرمنتيشن تيست. الشوجر فيرمنتيشن تيست بيفرق لي الفاميلي نايسيريا من بعض، بيفرق النايسيريا من انجيتيدس والنايسيريا جونوريا اللي هم باثوجينيك نايسيريا عن الكومنسال نايسيريا اللي هي النايسيريا فلافيسانس والنايسيريا سيك. نايسيريا من انجيتيدس فيرمنت جلوكوز اند مالتوز، نايسيريا جونوريا فيرمنت جلوكوز اونلي، نايسيريا فلافيسانس نوت فيرمنت اني شوجر، نايسيريا سكة فيرمنت اول شوجرز، اول ذا ثري شوجرز جلوكوز مالتوز اند ساكاروز. نايسيريا جونوريا فيرمنت جلوكوز اونلي وذ برودكشن اوف اسيد اونلي. نايسيريا منينجيتيدس فيرمنت جلوكوز اند مالتوز وذ برودكشن اوف اسيد اونلي. This test is important to differentiate family Neisseria members. After specimen collection, direct microscopic examination, cultivation والidentification of culture by colony morphology وfilm preparation and biochemical reactions, what else is done to diagnose Neisseria gonorrhea infection? Serology by fluorescent antibody staining or coagglutination tests, detection in nucleic acid by PCR or probes, ELISA test or blood culture test to diagnose disseminated gonococcal infection. After blood invasion ممكن ناخد blood sample ونعمل blood culture test. Finally, other sexually transmitted diseases as syphilis, non-gonococcal urethritis caused mainly by chlamydia trachomatis and HIV should be tested for because mixed infection is common. So we should test for other sexually transmitted diseases as syphilis, HIV, and non-gonococcal urethritis. Then, we will study spirochetes. What are spirochetes? They are long, slender, delicate, spiral, motile organisms. Motility by periplasmic internal flagella عليها الاندوفلاجيلا. Three pathogenic genera in this family: Treponema, Porelia and Leptospira. Treponema mainly Treponema pallidum cause syphilis. Other Treponema cause non-venereal infections called Lios والبنتا والبيجل. They are transmitted by direct contact. اللي يهمني تريبونيما بلدم اللي بتعمل syphilis which is sexual transmitted disease. Then البوريليا cause relapsing fever and Lyme disease. Then leptospira cause leptospirosis and Beale's disease. Genus Treponema زي ما قلنا include few pathogenic members أهمهم Treponema pallidum which cause syphilis. Other Treponema cause non-venereal infections as Lios, Penta and We will discuss in details Treponema pallidum which cause syphilis. What is the morphology of Treponema pallidum? They are delicate spiral organisms with small regular coils with characteristic motility. بنقول عليها corkscrew-like motility. تربونيما باليدم is not stained by Gram stain. امال بنشوفها ازاي؟ not stained بالجرام stain but seen by dark ground microscopy in unstained preparation or by silver impregnation or by immunofluorescence. 3 methods: dark ground microscopy in unstained preparations, silver impregnation and immunofluorescence. In dark ground microscopy they appear as spiral organisms. Light appear زي ما احنا شايفين كده ان هم منورين in a dark background. Brightly illuminated in a dark background. This is Treponema pallidum stained with silver stain. Appear as brown spiral organisms in a yellow background. Treponema pallidum with fluorescein dye. This is the morphology. This is Treponema pallidum with electron microscope. طبعا التكبير عالي فظاهر لي السبايرال لونج سبايرال organisms. Cultural characters Treponema pallidum not cultivated on artificial media. Serological characters here are important because serology is a main method of diagnosis of syphilis. Treponema pallidum stimulate formation of two types of antibodies. Treponemal antibody which react with Treponema suspension وده ال specific. Reagene antibody react with non-specific antigen called cardiolipine. Cardiolipine is alcoholic extract of beef heart muscle وده non-specific antibody. What is syphilis? Syphilis is sexually transmitted disease. What is the clinical presentation? 4 stages: primary syphilis, secondary syphilis, latent stage and tertiary stage and or tertiary syphilis. Primary syphilis characterized by the appearance of a lesion called chancre, which is hard painless ulcer. Develop 2 to 10 weeks after exposure at the site of inoculation, which is usually the genitalia. Appear as papule, undergo ulceration, regional lymph nodes become enlarged, then it will heal within 4 to 6 weeks even without treatment. Treponema pallidum is present in large numbers in chancre or in lesions of primary stage. This is important for diagnosis. Then secondary syphilis appear 6 to 12 weeks after appearance of chancre. This stage is characterized by generalized manifestations as skin rash, condylomata of anus and vulva, mucus patches of the mouth, and also Treponema pallidum is found in large numbers in lesions of this stage. This is also important for diagnosis. Treponema pallidum is present in large numbers in lesions of primary stage and secondary stage. This stage also characterized by systemic manifestations as fever, weight loss, joint pain, hair loss. These symptoms disappear spontaneously within 3 to 6 months. Then the disease undergo latent stage in which no signs or symptoms appear and may last for few months or for lifetime. الأورجانيزم is still present but cannot be detected in this stage but detected by positive serology. Thus, in primary and secondary syphilis, we can detect the organism in the lesions. In latent stage and in tertiary stage, the organism difficult to be detected directly, so it is detected by positive serology. In tertiary syphilis, it is characterized by appearance of granulomas called the gamma. Gammas appear in skin and bone, associated with CNS involvement in the form of varices or tapes dorsalis and cardiovascular lesions as the aortitis and the aortic aneurysm. This is the clinical picture of syphilis. If syphilis affects pregnant women, it may lead to congenital syphilis. Congenital syphilis acquired by the fetus from pregnant mother through the placenta may lead to abortion, stillbirth, or living baby develop congenital syphilis, present with interstitial keratitis, Hutchinson's teeth, saddle nose, and CNS anomalies. دي الكلينيكال بيكتشر كده باختصار بتاعة السيفيلس. Important for us in our lab diagnosis. Diagnose a case of syphilis. As we mentioned, in primary and secondary stages, the organism can be detected in the lesion. Detection of spirochetes in the lesion in primary and secondary stages. What is the sample? Serous exudate collected from the chancre in a primary stage or from skin lesions or skin rash or skin eruptions and mucus patches in secondary stage. How to detect the spirochetes? As we mentioned also before, they are not seen by Gram but detected by one of these methods. Dark ground microscopy will show living motile spirochetes with characteristic motility and angulation corkscrew-like motility or by direct immunofluorescence or by ELISA test or by PCR test which detects genome or by silver impregnation. Dark ground microscopy or silver impregnation or immunofluorescence or PCR test. ELISA rarely done as it lacks specificity. After primary and secondary stage, when the organism is difficult to be detected, serology is the gold standard for diagnosis. Serological diagnosis is essential in diagnosis of syphilis. We diagnose latent stage and tertiary stage by serology, the major diagnostic tool for syphilis. There are two types of serological tests according to the type of antigen. We mentioned that it stimulates production of reagene antibodies which are non-specific and react with the cardiolipin and other specific antibodies. Anti-treponemal antibodies which react specifically with treponema. So, according to the type of the antigen used, there are two types of tests. Non-treponemal antigen tests, هما non-specific, with treponemal antigen tests. Non-treponemal antigen tests are used to detect reagene antibody, which is non-specific antibody react with non-specific antigen called cardiolipin. As we mentioned, it is alcoholic extract of beef heart muscle. What are the tests of non-treponemal antigen? First is venereal disease research laboratory, which is a folliculation test done on a slide. The patient serum is heated and to be inactivated. Then mixed with a special cardiolipin antigen on a slide and shaken. If follicles occur, it is a positive test. These follicles are detected under the microscope. يعني بنجيب سلايد وبنحط عليها كارديولايبين انتيجين وبنجيب البيشنت سيرم بعد ما بنعمل له هيت ان اكتيفيشن وبنحطه على الانتيجين اللي على السلايد. لو ظهرت فولكيولز مايكروسكوبيكالي ديتكتد مايكروسكوبيكالي ذس از ا بوزيتيف تيست، لان السيرم بتاع العيان بيحتوي على رياجين انتي بودي عشان هو اللي بيعمل رياكشن مع الكارديولايبين انتيجين. This is venereal disease research laboratory test. Second test is rapid plasma reagent test. It is also folliculation test, but in this test we use black particles, black carbon particles. Thus, it can be detected macroscopically. يبقى في الـ venereal disease research laboratory كنا بنعمل detection microscopically. هنا كان we can detect microscopically as we use black particles. Then trust out toluidine red unheated serum test. برضو similar to rapid plasma reagent test، بس بدل ما كنا بنستخدم هناك black particles هنا بنستخدم ال red particles to visualize the reaction. This is the kits for rapid plasma reagent test. Non-treponemal antibody tests ليهم advantages ليهم disadvantages. هي الادفانتج بتاعتهم ان هم رابد وسيمبل وفي low cost. هي disadvantages ان هم non-specific زي ما قلنا، ان الانتيبادي ده non-specific and may give false positive results in other diseases as autoimmune diseases, measles, leprosy, الملاريا. So they are non-specific. ايه الـ uses بتاعتهم اذا كان هما non specific؟ بس الـ advantages اللي قلناها ان هما rapid و simple و low cost بتخليهم يستخدموا في اغراض معينة. ايه هي؟ used as screening test and epidemiological purposes as the positive results can be confirmed by one of specific tests. يبقى بنستخدمهم في الـ screening ولو طلع بوزيتيف بنعمل له كونفيرميشن بالسبيسيفيك تيست، لو طلع نيجاتيف خلاص. تاني حاجة ان هما can be used to evaluate the effect of treatment as they revert negative in 6 to 18 months after effective treatment. بيتحولوا النيجاتيف بعد حوالي 6 شهور من effective treatment، فبنستخدمهم to evaluate the effect of treatment، ودي ميزة مش موجودة في الأذر tests زي ما هنقول بعد شوية. دي non-treponemal antibody test. treponemal antigen tests اللي هما second category دول ميزتهم ان هما specific. they are confirmatory tests used as confirmatory tests as they have high specificity to detect anti-treponemal antibodies. What are their disadvantages? High cost, technical difficulties, remain positive for many years even after effective treatment. عشان كده بنستخدم non-specific tests for detection of effective treatment. What are treponemal antigen tests اللي هما specific tests؟ first of these are fluorescent treponemal antibody absorption test. فلوريسنت تريبونيمال انتي بودي ابسوربشن تيست، والتيست ده بيبقى عبارة عن indirect immunofluorescence. البيشنت سيرم is layered on killed treponema fixed on a slide then incubation for some time then fluorescein labeled anti-human gamma globulin is added and incubated. If fluorescence occur it is a positive serum. This test is sensitive and specific. يبقى fluorescent treponemal antibody absorption test indirect immunofluorescence test and it is sensitive and specific. Then second test is treponema pallidum heme agglutination test. It depends on the ability of antibodies in syphilitic patient serum to cause agglutination of sheep RBCs coated with an extract of treponema pallidum lead to heme agglutination of these RBCs. And this test is also sensitive and specific. If this test done in micro plates it is called micro heme agglutination assay for treponema pallidum. Okay, the third test ELISA or Western blotting done for detection of IgM and used mainly for diagnosis of congenital syphilis. Finally, rapid tests as a latex agglutination and immunochromatography are recently available tests done by commercially available kits for rapid detection of specific antibody antibodies to treponema pallidum in patient serum. These are the methods of diagnosis of syphilis. In primary and secondary stage, direct detection of treponema pallidum lesions. In latent and tertiary stage, gold standard or principal methods of diagnosis of syphilis, which is serology, specific treponemal antigen test non-specific treponemal antigen test. نعرف كل تيست اسمه البرنسبل بتاعه، ايه مميزات الجروب دي وعيوبها، وايه مميزات الجروب التانية وعيوبها. ده الدياجنوزيس اوف سيفيلس، ده بالنسبة لعيلة التريبونيم. بعد كده هندرس عن البوريليا. عيلة البوريليا three pathogenic species: البوريليا فينسنتي تعمل فينسنت انجينا، والبوريليا ريكارنتز، والبوريليا بيرجل ريفري. هنعرف ان البوريليا تعمل ريلابسينج فيفر. اللي احنا هنتكلم عنها بس هندي هنت عنها فينسنتي. بوريليا فينسنتي المورفولوجي بتاعهم هم جرام نيجاتيف spiral organisms. بنصبغهم او بنشوفهم بالفونتانا ستين appear as brown spirals in yellowish background. The cultural characters they are obligate anaerobes and they are very difficult to grow. بتعمل ايه البوريليا فينسنتي؟ بتعمل حاجة اسمها الفينسنت انجينا. البوريليا فينسنتي كومنسال بريزنت ان هيلثي هيومن ماوس كوز ديزيز اندر سيرتن كونديشنز از كونديشنز ويتش كوز انجري اور ديفيتاليزيشن اوف ميوكوس ميمبرينز. ذيس نورمالي اوكيرينج ماوس سبايروكيتس توجذر ويز حاجه اسمها بنقول عليها الفيوزو بكتيريا which are cigar shaped fusiform bacilli multiply in the lesions lead to the formation of ulcers on the tonsils and gums followed by pseudomembrane formation. This pseudomembrane contain pus cells and necrotic tissue. This clinical picture should be differentiated from diphtheria and follicular tonsillitis. This is the morphology of the shape of Vincent angina ulcer in the mouse. Here to diagnose Vincent angina, our sample is swab from ulcer. Vincent angina is diagnosed by direct microscopic examination. Direct smear, direct gram stained smear. Stained with gram stain, we will see large number of gram negative spirochetes, gram negative Borrelia vincenzi, and gram negative fusobacteria, which appear as cigar shape. Gram negative long bacilli with tapering ends. This is the morphology of direct smear of Vincent angina, as we see gram negative spirochetes and gram negative cigar shaped fusiform bacilli. That's all about our lab today. Neisseria gonorrhea and methods of diagnosis of gonorrhea, Treponema pallidum and methods of diagnosis of syphilis, Borrelia vincenti and diagnosis of Vincent angina. Let's have a rapid review. What are the methods of diagnosis of gonorrhea? Neisseria gonorrhea smear and fill. Neisseria gonorrhea culture. Neisseria gonorrhea biochemical reactions and differentiation between its sugar fermentation and sugar fermentation of Neisseria meningitidis. Treponema pallidum by dark ground microscope. Treponema pallidum by silver stain. Treponema pallidum with fluorescein dye. Treponema pallidum with electron microscope. Diagnosis of Vincent angina by direct smear. Thank you. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.